In this tutorial, we will look at the Shapiro Library resources that are applicable to environmental science courses, how to find them, and how to use them within the scope of your project. As we look at the Shapiro Library homepage, there are a few avenues where we could begin our search. The multi-search, or the main search box in the middle of the screen, searches the majority of our databases, which can be great for beginning research and casting a wide net over many disciplines. It doesn't necessarily delve deeply into any one discipline, and for our purposes, we will look at the environmental science and science-related databases. The A to Z database list provides the full list of our online library collection and can be filtered by disciplines like biology, computer science, environmental studies, and more, and further narrowed by the type of source like ebooks, reports and data, scholarly publications, and primary sources. Another way to access resources, and the approach we will take during this video, is to use one of the research guides that has been created for your field of study. As we click on the research guides link in the top navigation, you will see a wide variety of guides that have been created around topics, specific courses, and disciplines like environmental science. As we bring up the environmental science research guide, you will notice a splash page with an RSS feed, Environmental Science News. Navigation tabs are on the left-hand side of the screen, and more recommended guides offering a similar layout and perhaps overlapping content are below. As you approach your project, we can think about research in different ways. One method is to divide library research into background research, current research, and research on the areas that are in development process, but not quite through the proving phase. Each of these areas plays a role in how it can be incorporated into and inform your project. Let's start with the idea of background research. Background research is helpful to familiarize yourself with the concept and its associated research avenues, and it also equips you with the vocabulary you will need to search more effectively. For background research, encyclopedias, books, and other reference sources can be helpful to better understand a topic. For example, if you're interested in invasive species, we might start with the database Credo Reference, which is a collection of online encyclopedias, dictionaries, and other reference sources. Environmental sciences, in general, is listed on the homepage of this database. However, we don't see our topic listed, so we'll do a keyword search in the search bar. As you look through the results, you see the title of the entry, the source, the word count, and some key concepts included in the article. I'm going to choose the entry on plants, which has a fairly substantial word count. As I mentioned earlier, you can begin to see the topic from a holistic perspective, and through the keywords and glossary, you gain a vocabulary which will be used by researchers as they are writing scholarly articles. By speaking the same language, so to speak, you're able to search for scholarly information later on more effectively. I also like that this particular entry suggests avenues for future research, which can aid you in identifying which research path you might choose. Another important source of information for background knowledge comes from books. As we navigate to the Finding Books and eBooks tab, you'll find sample eBooks, which can help you narrow your focus toward a particular topic, and also provide that holistic overview of a research area. As I don't see anything related to invasive species listed, my next step would be to research for an eBook. For the sake of time, I'm going to open this book, Trends in Environmental Science, to familiarize you with the interface. As you can see, the chapters tackle different aspects of environmental science, which leads me to say you don't necessarily need to read the entire book to inform yourself on a topic. It might just be one or two chapters you want to focus on. While the first part of this video focused on background research on the topic as a whole, we are shifting a bit to look at research found in scholarly articles and also research that appears in conference proceedings, both of which you may find through the Shapiro Library Collection. If we now have a concept which we would like to further explore in more depth, we can look at some of the other recommended databases. In this case, we will remain on the Environmental Science Guide, but move to the Finding Articles section. As I've been living in New Hampshire a while now, I know that the Japanese knotweed is an invasive species that is popping up all over the place, and that will be the example we use when searching our database, like Environmental Complete. You can make the search as simple or as complicated as you like. If we simply put in the terms Japanese knotweed, we come up with 240 titles. Although the selection of articles may not be focused on New Hampshire, we can extrapolate with the information presented. The articles discuss eradication and control from a variety of perspectives. As we look at the results, I want to point out that some of the mechanics of the database, namely opening the PDF, which can be saved to your computer. We also have the other key terms we can use to find similar articles. Important information like the date when the article was published, and using the article for references included to see if a particular article has been cited by another publication. All of these routes help to round out your literature search. As we head back to the library homepage, I want to note again the multi-search. Since it covers a broad swath of disciplines, let's see what happens when we put in Japanese knotweed and New Hampshire. There aren't too many results, but that's okay. As I mentioned earlier, the search is really skimming the surface of many databases, and I might try this exact search in an environmental science database to see what I find. It also brings up another avenue for me to investigate, which is from a policy perspective. You may want to search government sites for New Hampshire to see how cities and towns are addressing this issue. From this first article, I might also research the chemical treatments that are suggested and learn more about their effects on the environment. Earlier, I mentioned conference proceedings, which are included in many of our research databases. Thinking of the timeline as to how information is published, conference proceedings generally represent a phase during or slightly after the research process, intended to let other scholars know about the findings, which will later be submitted as an article for publication in a scholarly journal. As you are looking at the source type or document type of a publication, conference proceedings can be an important source to find the latest research on a topic. Research like this is meant to inform how you approach your topic and also supports why you chose a specific solution. Your instructors will want to know how you came to the conclusion. The more supporting information you provide, the better understanding you will have of your topic, and you will make a more compelling argument for your hypothesis. As we look at the library homepage, know that you have some more support from the reference team, which is available through the options in the upper right-hand corner, chat, email, and phone. And your professors may refer you to a subject-specific librarian at SNHU.